This century is going to be the century of emerging technologies in the life sciences field.
We're now at a period of our understanding of the human body that we can begin to seriously think not about treatments, but about cures.
But I don't think that an individual scientist really knows exactly how to take the basic science discovery and make that a drug that we can actually bring to market. So the idea here is, let's collaborate with the best and the brightest scientists. Let's bring people to Harvard Business School, give them an MBA, but also give them amazing science education, which allows them to lead the next generation of biopharma companies.
We're excited to launch this new MS MBA program because it fills a need of people who'd like to make a difference in the world by developing new drugs and new medicines. They already know enough science to see the promise, but what they're missing is a business sense of how to commercialize science.
My guess is in a decade, you will be hard-pressed to get a position in a biotech or pharma company without having had an experience like this. The core of the curriculum is an understanding of how to take opportunities to invest and evaluate them scientifically, medically, and ethically.
Students in this program will have access to HBS faculty members and faculty members from the Faculty of Arts and Sciences and Harvard Medical School present in the classroom at the same time.
We're delighted to collaborate between my department and the Harvard Business School. Business School has a tradition and a history of excellence in training managers and leaders in new areas.
But one also needs mastery of the basic science. And what better place to learn that from than the Department of Stem Cell and Regenerative Biology? They've thought long and hard to do science to heal humanity.
I can't imagine a better place to have this kind of program than in Boston.
Because it is, at the moment, the biomedical capital of the world.
There is no other city in the world that has the agglomeration of industry, hospitals, scientists, and great universities, all sitting a mile and a half apart from each other.
I'm excited about the prospect that we're going to attract really ambitious people who think that they can completely change the way we think about treating disease.
In other words, we want to provide leadership for the whole scientific medical enterprise.
The people who believe it is within our scientific and economic grasp to reduce human suffering in the world. Those are the people who should definitely apply.